Good afternoon, Penn High School, and thanks for tuning in to your spring break edition of PNN. I'm Zach.
And I'm Jared Woods. And we're going to give you news and announcements for today, March 31st.
Hey, you want to take this one to me?
No, you can go ahead.
Awesome. Attention, seniors.
Psych. It's me. It's my show. Hey, seniors, Jocelyn's will be here Friday, April 15th, during A Lunch to deliver cap and gowns. If you still have a balance due, you can pay it on Jocelyn's website or call them. And if you haven't placed your order yet, you should probably do that. Like me.
Yeah, you should.
Yeah. Just go, yeah.
The Penn Choir left yesterday for Ireland. The Penn Jazz Band left earlier this week for a conference. And the Penn Orchestra left for a New York field trip this morning. We all wish you guys a safe travels and a happy spring break. I wish we could go somewhere.
Now to PNN weatherman Joe Bursley for your spring weather forecast.
Happy Thursday, Penn High School. I am PNN weatherman Joe Bursley coming to you one final time before radio release to enjoy our spring break. I hope you are all enjoying these last few days before spring break, and I want to make the time to bring you a special spring break edition of my weather segment. To start off, today we have a high of 64 degrees with some afternoon thunderstorms and wind gusts. Those showers and winds will make it feel cooler than it actually is, so take caution when you're heading outside today. For Friday, we have cloudy skies outside and a heat wave of 50 degrees. Isn't that spring weather just astounding? Come on, Mother Nature, don't hold back. Really. Let's see if Saturday gets any better. Spoke too soon. High of only 43 degrees and a chance of afternoon showers makes you think we are in the wrong season. For those of you staying in the bleak Michiana area, prepare to be disappointed. I have here the spring break forecast for our area next week. On Monday, we have a mix of rain and snow showers, and we have some more showers later on into the week near Friday and Saturday. Also, the warmest we can expect to get is 56 degrees, and that is only once. Temperatures in the 40s for the most part, making this spring break one I hope I can soon forget. Before we leave, I want to give you all a forecast that will be more applicable to the majority of students here, one for Miami, Florida. I'm sure you're all ecstatic to be migrating south to beaches, sunshine, and generally warmer weather, and you can expect just as much. Besides a chance of thunderstorms on Sunday, the week is going to be pretty mild with sunny skies or partly cloudy skies. Also, temperatures in the 70s with highs around 80 degrees. Have you ever tried talking about weather of somewhere warmer than where you live? Take it from me, it's quite depressing. Anyway, I hope you all have a fun, enjoyable, and safe spring break. Emphasis on fun, enjoyable, and safe. I will see you all when you fly back in from Florida in a week. Until then, have a wonderful time listening to these crucial news and announcements.
Thanks, Joe.
Prom is a four-letter word that will grab the attention of any upperclassman. Better start buying those dresses because Penn Prom will be held on Saturday, May 14th. This event will be held at the Century Center in the South Bend.
So we're going to toss it over to Tyler Miller with sports in a short break. Stay tuned.
Hello, Penn High School. I'm here to catch you up with all things Penn sports. The women's softball team beat Portage 11-0 in five innings, with Daniel Watson throwing a one-hitter with five strikeouts in five innings. Hallie Hicksonball drove in four runs, Olivia McGaldy drove in two runs, and Alyssa Grimman hit a home run. Come out and support the women as they take on Lake Central at home today, March 31st at 5:30. The men's track team traveled to Warsaw to start off the track season. Caden Paquette won the discus, Matt McCown won the high jump, and Dylan Hill won the 200. In the 400, Elijah Cook placed second and Grant Miller placed third. In the 1600, Colton Shale placed second. In the 200 hurdles, Bailey Mott placed second and Drew Brady placed third. John Olson placed second in the long jump. In the 100 high hurdles, Drew Brady placed second. In the 800, Reese Kennedy placed third. In the 100 and 200, Andy Doty placed third. And Trenton Horvath, John Olson, Andy Doty, and Dylan Hill placed second in the 4x1. Penn is hosting a dodgeball tournament, and all profit goes to the American Cancer Society. Here's Mr. Ball and Mr. Harper with more.
First of all, to all Penn faculty and staff, we're having a dodgeball tournament on April 28th right here in the arena as well as the auxiliary gym. You can sign up by seeing Mr. Cantoni. He has plenty of registration forms, or myself in room 257. So get a team and help others.
How many people are on each team?
Each team has eight members, but you can have up to 10. Only eight play at a time. And it should be a lot of fun. And the bonus is it goes to the American Cancer Society to help eradicate this terrible disease. All monies, all fees collected turn into myself or Mr. Cantoni. make any checks payable to the American Cancer Society. We're going to do pool play, and so we'll put the teams in pools, and each pool will play each other team, and then we'll have a tournament of the pool winners, and hopefully have a good time. Penn teachers will be involved. We have an administrative team, so we have teams from Schmucker and Grissom Discovery. So get a team together, help others, and have a good time doing it.
Here we go. Coach Harper here. Just throwing a shout out to all the students and staff members. We have our dodgeball tournament April 28th. It's for cancer. It's for a good cause. And I don't want to brag or anything, but we are returning champions, and I plan on dominating this tournament again. So I challenge any student try to put a team together and beat me. All right? See if you can bring it and beat my team this year. It's not going to happen, but you can try. All right? You know, it'll be a good effort for you guys to try. So I challenge everyone to come to the dodgeball tournament. It's going to be an outstanding event this year. It's going to be bigger, better, and it's going to be exciting. All right? It's going to be thunder and lightning. You don't want to miss it, students and staff members of Penn High School. So bring the dodge. Go Penn.
Thanks, guys. The Penn baseball team beat Northridge 8-2. Matt Combo had two RBIs. Skylar Sinski earned the win while pitching five innings with 11 strikeouts. Their next game is Friday, April 6th, at home against the 11th-ranked Fort Wayne Carroll in 4A at 1 p.m. In basketball, Cameron Burr scored 17 points in the local women's McDonald's All-Star game, and Lindsay Chris scored 6 in the game. Matt Torella scored 17 points in the men's McDonald's All-Star game. Good luck to all Penn teams competing over spring break. That's all I have for you today, Penn. I'm Tyler Miller. Now back to your news and announcements at the desk.
Okay, here we go, Penn High School. We have spring break upon us.
I'm super excited for all of us to have some time to spend with friends and family and just to get some good rest and relaxation, which I'm sure all of us need at this point.
So as you head into spring break, there's just a couple of things we as a staff wanted you guys to remember.
When you have a little bit more freedom and you're not worried about tomorrow's classes and making the grade.
Go eat the food, go talk to people. Just remember who you are.
And you have options offered you. Just because you can doesn't mean you should.
Your teachers admire you and your family loves you very much. You're very important to a lot of people.
I can't really express to you how serious these things are and how serious it is when a young person loses his or her life.
March 28, 1999 was a horrible day for my school and for one of my former students.
It's just so tragic, all of that lost potential, and the impact that it has not only on your immediate family, but the entire community.
On the way home from spring break, one of my former students, Chris Edison, was killed in a car wreck by a drunk driver.
Here at Penn High School, remember that Kingsmen take care of ourselves, and also that Kingsmen take care of one another.
So when you go out spring break, be safe, look after each other, and make good choices. It's very important.
I want to remind you to make good choices.
No matter if you're staying here or you're traveling, have a great time, recharge your batteries, and have a lot of fun.
This spring break should be one to remember for the right reasons.
Be smart. Do not drink and drive. Do not ride with somebody else who's been drinking.
As you're hanging out this week, to be mature and really care for yourself and care for others.
And do not mix prescription drugs with energy drinks, other drugs, illicit drugs. It's not worth it.
But remember to do what's right. There's a lot of people that love you and care about you, and we want you all back safe. So again, have a great spring break.
Enjoy your spring break. Have an awesome time.
And come back to us safe and sound when we come back from spring break, because that was an awful feeling not having one of our former students with us.
You understand? Here we go. Have a good spring break, Penn High School, and go Penn.
Welcome back, y'all.
It looks like that's all we have for you today.
Is that it?
That's it.
You want this for life, take it. I'm Jared.
I'm Zach.
And I'm not gonna say that. Spend your week with your families, friends, and Netflix accounts. Relax and enjoy your week without homework.
A little soft homework. We'll see you all on April 11th. Penn High School.
Peace out, y'all.
Bye.
And as people in PNN can't tell, we are back. And thank you, Elizabeth, for that interview. All right. Let's go. Thank you for that interview.